Palangka Nation, we are here now with Miguel Syjuco, the Palangka Award and Man Asia Award winning writer of Ilustrado. Miguel, thank you so much for joining us and congratulations.
Yes, it's a pleasure to be here.
So what inspired you to write the book Ilustrado?
Wow, I wanted to write about the Philippine experience from the point of view of a writer trying to write about the Philippine experience.
Huh.
So I created this,
exactly. Very circular. I like it.
I created this character, Crispin Salvador, who was a great man of letters. And within the book that I've made, I've excerpted from all of his life's work. So fiction, memoir, his poetry, his interviews, blog entries, jokes that he shares with his young student.
His body floating in the Hudson had been hooked by a Chinese fisherman.
And because I've been able to do that, I've been able to chart 150 years of Philippine history. Because it's so complicated, we like to deal in absolutes, rich and poor, you know, mestizo versus not mestizo, or Indio or whatever. No offense.
Go on.
educated versus masa or whatever. And we deal with these dichotomies, when in reality, it's the complications, the nuance, the gray areas in between them that really is the story. Because I'm writing a novel about the Philippines, I want it to be an examination of the things that we don't often talk about. That's the message.
I think that's great. And I think it's definitely worth taking a look at it and having a deeper kind of dialogue with ourselves and with other Filipinos about what it is to be Filipino. But still, this is a book of fiction. So what part of it is fiction? What part of it is fact?
Well, it is a book of fiction. It's a novel. So it's all of it is fiction. But I've mixed, you know, real people with fictional people. I've put in real names or names that sound similar. But when in reality, it really is all a work of fiction, because I want the reader to always be wondering, well, you know, why is the main character named Miguel Syjuco? And if Miguel Syjuco is a real person and what is being written in this possibly could be real, then maybe Crispin Salvador, the other main character, is real. And then maybe all of these other things that we were reading about the Philippines are also real. Because I want the reader to get to the end and wonder, you know, what is real and what isn't, and come to the conclusion that, well, it doesn't really matter. It's fiction, and it might not be factual, but it hits at truths.
So on the level of literature, let's move on to the fact that you have won the Man Asian Literary Prize and the Palangka Award, which is the highest award that you can get in Philippine literature.
Yes.
Getting that so early, well, this is your first published novel, yes?
Yes, it is.
And so how does that affect your future writing career?
And now having won these prizes, having published now, I have a little bit more confidence that what I'm trying to do aren't so crazy.
That's great. So the title of the book is Ilustrado, mm-hmm. and it refers to, you know, our ancestors, the enlightened ones, mm-hmm. who went abroad for studying in Spain and, you know, elsewhere in the world, and came back and actually applied their knowledge to help Filipinos in their struggle at that time for independence.
In 1896, yeah.
Yeah. Is that something that's on your radar? Are you going to be the modern day Ilustrado who takes all of his knowledge and his accomplishments and actually goes back home to the Philippines?
Well, you know, I mean, that's a great question. I mean, I deal with the Ilustrados because it is historical fiction.
Mm-hmm.
The book charts 150 years of Philippine history. But I also want to turn that idea of Ilustrado on its head and discuss how we Filipinos, there are 9 million of us living abroad, have the potential to go back also and be the modern day Ilustrados. I myself, you know, I mean, I'm just a guy who writes. I'm trying my best to learn all I can. I would like to one day be able to share what I can with the Filipinos, either through teaching or whatnot. But I'm sharing with them the story of ourselves. And I'm also trying to explain to the rest of the world, you know, how we became who we are. What are the events and what are the issues and what are the challenges that we faced in the last 2 centuries that made us Filipino. But, you know, I mean, I'm not an Ilustrado. I'm just a guy who sits at home and writes.
Right.
I'm still learning. I'm still trying to make a career and figure out how to be a writer.
So I'll wait 10 more years and ask
you
that question again.
Exactly.
And one last thing, Miguel, for all the aspiring writers out there who are watching you, Filipinos all over the world see the mm-hmm. show, what advice do you have to give them?
I think you should read as much as you can. listen to everybody, but also don't listen to anybody at all, and just believe in what you're doing. And know that writing is actually revising. I mean, writing to me is the hardest thing I've ever done, and that's probably why I do it. Mm-hmm. And if you're not prepared to sacrifice and pursue it relentlessly and put the blood on the page, then, you know, maybe you should think of something else.
Well, it's a wonderful, complicated book, but it's definitely worth the read. Ilustrado by Miguel Syjuco. In bookstores right now, mga Konation, please go out and support our fellow Filipino artists. Miguel, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.